Before we get them to play, though, we might get them out for a bit of a chat. Please make them welcome from the Living End. Chris and Scott. Chris and Andy. Welcome. 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 Right. Have a seat. We're one man down. We're a man down.
Man down.
Man down.
Man down. There's no going back.
He's not allowed to talk.
There's no going back.
No, he's currently indisposed.
He plays bass much better.
Really?
Mm.
I hear that some people who, you know, do vocals have to warm up for several hours before a performance. Is that what's going on here?
No. I think he's...
What's no, he honestly.
No, honestly.
Oh, we do, but not for several hours, for, you know, maybe 20 minutes or something.
20 minutes before the gig. Now, it's all happening for you guys at the moment. So there's a bit of a tour on, there's a new record on, you've got a cult following everywhere you go.
Aren't they beautiful?
Yeah. Good. Except for him.
Except for him. Well, he's getting paid to be here.
Yeah.
So, you know, that's why he's come along.
Are we getting paid?
Well, we'll talk about that after the interview.
Okay.
All right. But
It is busy. We've been overseas all year pretty much, and we haven't toured here since last year. And it's just starting to get busy in the last 48 hours. It's gotten really busy.
Hopefully we'll ramp that up over the next 20 minutes
please,
as well.
Please.
But over in the States, overseas, were you surprised by just the level of intensity you're getting at your gigs over there?
It was good. It was fun.
Was it intense?
Was it intense?
No, it was in venues, not
always
tense.
Yeah, we played a lot of outdoor with you know, roofs and things, but I think we did play a tent one day at a festival.
We did.
Mm. We're on the tent stage. But it was intense. It was fun, and the crowds were great.
But they're not as good as here, and I'm not just saying that.
No. Well, they got funny accents.
Security.
Yeah. Well, can we have him thrown out? Yeah. The blonde guy at the back. Yeah,
what?
Just him.
What did I do?
That's the one. Have him removed. He's a nuisance. But you obviously are always happy to come back here. And I've noticed that on top of putting out this record,
The singles.
There's a DVD as well, and it's got a little film on that. Have you just shot so much stuff over the years, you thought, bugger it.
Let's put out
a film.
Yeah. Chris is big with guns. He just shoots things all the time.
Yeah.
No, there's that went down
that
really
was,
well.
That was what? I thought my joke was
I preferred intense myself.
That works well. There's just footage from way back when Chris was a young fella.
Yep. We actually didn't think we'd have enough footage when we had the idea of the DVD. I thought, we don't really have footage of us smashing too much stuff up, and we don't have too much footage of girls' breasts, which is normally what you associate
They're
with rock and roll DVDs.
Yeah.
But funnily enough, when we saw the footage, there was quite a lot of interesting stuff on there that, without boobs and, you know, smashing stuff, it's still an interesting enough story without that. Probably not going to sell now because I've just given that away, but
there are tits ahoy from here on in the DVD. Just look out for it. No. I'm sure. Whose job was it to trawl through all those hours of vision?
There's a guy called JT who'd done some video clips of ours before, and he actually shot a lot of it. And yeah, he had what did he have? He had like four categories.
Oh yeah. We can't really say.
No, it was like, you know, no good, good, great, pure effing gold.
Yeah,
and, fantastic.
So, yeah, we ended up having a lot more, and I think it's 2 hours, the documentary, and it could have gone for another hour, he said, but we didn't want it to be a mini-series, so we thought we'd better cut it there.
Well, that's a good idea.
Well, there's a whole lot of great stuff there, and there's a whole lot of great fans who are here. You've sold out a heap of shows, and these people didn't pay anything to be here. They've just got here from early in the morning to catch you perform live this afternoon. Jeez, with some of them backstage.
John's got a question for you. What's your question, mate?
How you going, Chris and Andy?
G'day.
I heard that Green Day, when they heard your demo, gave you the big break way back like 5-6 years ago. I was just wondering, when they come out later this year, earlier next year, are you going to tour with them?
I'd love to, but we've actually toured with them twice now, once in Australia and once in America. So to do it again, you know, I think we should give someone else a go. Although, if they asked, yes, we'd probably do it again. But I don't think they'll ask.
They are big fans of yours, aren't they?
Yeah, they're really nice guys, actually. We've sort of become friends with them, you know, now. We started out as fans, but now we met up with them last summer in America. And, yeah, they're just really so down to earth, you know.
They're always singing your praises. And we had Blink-182 on the show only a couple of weeks ago, and they were giving you massive raps as well. It's always nice, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
Especially coming from guys like that.
Mm.
Yeah.
Well, they're mental, so, you know.
Yeah.
You're going to get that. G.E.A.'s also got another fan who's been here since early this morning.
This is Matt. What's your question?
Chris, who are your major influences on the guitar?
Let me think. Probably a whole lot of unknown people, really, to you guys. But Chet Atkins, Brian Setzer, Angus Young. Look, you know, heaps of people. Way too many to mention, but they'd be, you know, three of the main ones. Yeah.
Cool.
Fair enough. Cool. Well, we might let you get ready, warm up, get in the zone, get in the moment, and perform for all these people who've been here for a long time. It's got to be heartening for you guys. So I guess, you know, you play a lot of shows in pubs and clubs and people over 18, and you try and squeeze the odd under 18 show in there, but to know that there's all these young people out there gagging to hear you play.
It's excellent. Yeah, we always want to do under 18s. It's a matter of just trying to do them. But, yeah, it seems that the fan base is kind of getting bigger and younger, which is great.
Bigger. Yeah. It's growing every day. It's been a frantic 48 hours. We're going to up the ante for you in the next little bit by getting you to play live, guys, in just moments. The Living End performing live. In the meantime, this is Killing Heidi on What You Want. Up next, The Living End. Every Saturday, we do our very best to bring you some live music. Sometimes it's international, sometimes it's local. And today it's very special.
And they're always bloody good. We are very, very happy to have them here with us. They rocked on the Detour earlier in the year. They've been to the States. They've come back. The singles album From Here On In is on the shelves. Go and buy it. Would you give it up for a big bloody live set from The Living End?
Searching for a passion, overpaid and overrated, looking for a cash in. past when the union made it clear. My spirit's sorely faded, your aim was getting near. See, you're all expendable when all is said and done. You go back to where tomorrow meets your new three faces.
Hang on a second. I gotta pull my pants up. Make sure everything's tucked in. And, because this next song's pretty fast, right? So we can't be wearing jackets and stuff. It's only the third song, man. And, well, hang on, I've come out of my pocket. It's all good. Come on, make some noise. That's what you're supposed to do on television. Here we go. Sounds called Hold Up. Daniel McAllister. Where's Daniel McAllister? On your phone. He must be small. Hope your phone doesn't break. Okay. Yeah. Comedy's not our routine. Here we go. Have a pick.
All right.
This one's called... This next song is a song about a prostitute that Andy used to know very, very well, I might add. And it's called My Friend the Prostitute. We'll be right back. Okay. How we doing, all right? How we doing, Andrew, all right? Yeah, we love Iron. There's a guy in the crowd with an Iron Maiden t-shirt. Where is he? Oh, there he is, there he is. What the hell? I'm tuning, but I'm not looking at the tuner. Hang on.
It's an ancient traditional Chinese song he's playing called Tuning.
Yeah, unfortunately, we'll be here all week.
It's ancient and traditional.
That sounds good. He's there. That guy's kneeling down like he's at church or something. Okay, here we go. Now this song's for the guy in the Iron Maiden t-shirt and any other metalheads here tonight. Don't be afraid. It's okay to be a metalhead. Is that going to include liking, ACDC? The Darkness? Metallica, Ozzy Osbourne? And Missy Higgins? Yeah. I don't know where that came from, but this song's all about drinking alcohol, listening to heavy metal. We're just going to do one more, right? Then it's back to the usual programming and, I don't know, all the parents will tune back in. Okay. We have to, oh man, look, we'd love to play all night, we really would. Actually, we are going to be playing all night. But not here, somewhere else in Sydney. So thanks for having us. Thanks to Channel V. Thanks to you guys. Be safe. Here we go.
They're touring to Darwin. All the dates on our website, channelv.com.au. Most of the songs you just heard are on that fantastic compilation, The Living End, from here on in. The singles. Thank you guys so much for everything. Thank you so very much. That was so, so great. And two incredibly frantic fans in the front row, Jimmy.
Yes, they pushed their way forth. And they danced their asses off. Hannah and Deborah, did you enjoy that?
Yes!
You're very excited to be here, aren't you?
Yes!
Living in one of your favourite bands?
Yes.
Who's another one of your favourite bands that you'd like to see right now?
Franz Ferdinand.
Fantastic. For Hannah and Deborah, everyone here at VHQ, this is...